Today, I will show you how to design a vintage logo design with Illustrator in the step-by-step, easy-to-follow tutorial. What is up, people? Friday is here and I hope you're having a great start to your weekend. Today, a vintage logo design tutorial in Illustrator. Remember, if you find this tutorial helpful, let me know in the comment section below and like and share this video. Create a new document in Illustrator and then turn your fill off and activate the stroke. You can use any color, it doesn't really matter at this stage. Grab the pen tool and make a mountain peak outline like so. Once you've connected and closed the path, flick it over to a fill. Deselect the mountain peak by clicking the outboard, and then add a different color to the stroke palette. We're going to make two shapes that will resemble the snow on the mountain slope. Once you have your two shapes, hold down Shift and use the selection tool to click both at the same time, and then flick the snow shapes over to a fill. You can then take the direct selection tool to edit the anchor points of the snow and mountain, adjusting your shape to how you want it to look. There is our mountain shape for our vintage logo design pretty much complete. We need to open up the Pathfinder window for the next step. Again, hold down Shift and then select both the snow shapes with the selection tool and unite them in the Pathfinder window. They are now essentially on the same layer and united. Select the snow and the mountain and use the minus front option in the Pathfinder, which will cut out the snow from the mountain. Everything is now one shape. If you want, you can use the round corners effect to add to the logo design. Select the polygon tool and double click the artboard. We want to add 6 sides, and the other measurements are not so crucial. Change the weight here to something you feel looks good for a vintage logo design. Now move your mountain icon into place in a similar position to mine. Use the selection tool to select the polygon and then outline the stroke like so. Now you cannot change the weight of the polygon shape. Grab the pen tool and hold down Shift to create a perfectly straight line across, and then continue the path around like so. Select all three shapes holding down Shift, and then unite them from the Pathfinder window. Now we're going to add some text with the type tool, which you can access by pressing T on your keyboard. The typeface I'm using is Go Bold. I would suggest a sans serif font that is quite bold. Change the color of your text to white and then move it into place. You can resize it by holding down Shift and using the selection tool. Now we need to grab the star tool and double click the artboard. Use 5 points and hit generate. You can use a guide to make sure the star is level like I am doing here. To open up the rulers, hit Command R or Control R on a PC. Once your star is in place, hold down Alt until you see this icon appear, and then click and drag to duplicate it. Move it over to the side, and then you can align them both along a horizontal plane like so. Select the text and create outlines of your type. Hold down Shift and select both stars and the type, and then unite them in the Pathfinder window. Once you've done that, select the newly united shape and the mounted icon and minus from front in the Pathfinder window. Now we have one cutout logo design. The final touch is going to be to add the vintage style effect. First, you can use a direct selection tool to round off the corners like so. Uniting the shape previously erased the round corners effect. You can also go up to effect and round corners like we did before. Move the logo aside and create a black rectangle using the rectangle tool over the entire artboard. Then lock the layer like so. Turn your logo design to white and bring it to the front, and then move it over to the black background. You'll need to open up the transparency window to create the vintage effect to our logo design. Click Make Mask and uncheck the clip option. Your window should look like this. In the description, there is a link for this vector download. And once you open it, you will notice everything is grouped together. You're going to have to ungroup everything twice, and then select one section that you want to use. Hit Command C to copy it. Make sure the right box is selected and hit Command V or Control V on the PC to paste the vector in place. You can hold down Alt and Shift at the same time to resize your vector proportionally. Once you're happy, simply click off the transparency window. You can keep adding grunge vectors over the top, making sure that you add them onto the right box in the transparency window. You can see here I have two vectors in place. Now I have three in place. You can play around with layering vectors up on your logo design. You can also change the color of your vintage logo design to whatever you wish. I really like this effect, and the fact that it's a vector means it will be able to be scaled up and down to any size whilst retaining quality. You can put the grunge effect onto your text as well. So, did you find this vintage style logo design tutorial helpful? Let me know in the comment section below. Like, share, and subscribe for my 5 weekly uploads. And until next time, design your future today. Peace.